Okay, so I'm going to give a brief introduction to our final speaker today, Zoran Hochstatter. Zoran is a specialist in bioenergy therapy and is the teacher of pure bioenergy healer in energy, a powerful way of energy healing without any cultural, political, religious, ritualistic, or medical additives. Since 2007, Zoran has taught hundreds in pure bioenergy healing seminars in the USA, Canada, and the UK, and is the founder of the Bioenergy Life Center. Zoran offers all of the levels of practical training to become a certified pure bioenergy practitioner. Anyone can do this. He helps people all around the world by giving in-person, long-distance therapy or through his Bioenergy Life Center group healing events. He'll be telling you about that. You can go for 4 nights, 2 hours a night, and get free healing from him and his students. Now I want you to meet a real modern-day Jedi, Zoran Hochstatter.
If you can't hear me right. You know, I speak a lot to a lot of people, but I'm still nervous because I don't know you. I don't know you by the end of this. This is what you see here. It's psychokinesis. This is not what I'm going to be talking about, but it's a little part of it. So if you want to leave it up there, it's fine. Or what I'm going to be talking about is what I do. And makes me very humble to talk about what I do after all these people spoke of all this great stuff that I don't do. I do energy healing. I use bioenergy, chi, ki, prana. This is all the same thing. But I have to say, I have this, human superpower, but I've never seen energy. I've never seen an aura. I've never seen any of that, which is good for you because that means that if you haven't seen, if you have seen it, that's good. But me, even without seeing it, without knowing how that looks, that means that you can do it too. Because my believing was always that we all can do this. Now, you have to learn certain things, how to get there. But it's very simple, actually. And it's simple because I'm talking about healing. I'm not talking about ascending or going somewhere. I'll be here for a little bit longer. I'm just fine and comfortable here, but that vibration, that raising of vibration, that becoming more different comes by itself. I didn't want to say better because there is no better force, but there is what my powers, not powers, it's knowledge. What this knowledge does comes, all the powers come from by themselves, by me using the knowledge. And you can get that knowledge too. The knowledge is just information. And this is what I will in a minute let you see with psychokinesis. So what I do, I don't have, it's very actually pedestrian. A lot of people just come to me with frozen shoulders or whatever they have, and diabetes and cancer or indigestion, whatever. And so of course, it's all connected to something else. It's all connected to your higher self, your all the other conditions, to your psyche, to your emotions, to everything else. But you, or that person that comes to me, has a problem with the elbow. Now, that problem in the elbow comes from somewhere else too, but that's not important to me. And it's certainly not important to a person that was in pain. When Darcy came to me, this was a great, Darcy, thank you very much. The flowers go to you for that advertising for me. It was fantastic. She was in pretty bad shape. But see, she didn't care whether her aura is yellow or if her aura has a dark tint around it. And that would be probably from her mom. But I couldn't let that pass. So that didn't matter to her. She was in pain. She couldn't stand up. She couldn't sit up. She couldn't sleep. That's the problem. So we're talking about the manifestations. And what I do is I deal with the manifestations, with the physical manifestations. Of course, I have to address the other layers and other outer higher reasons why her physical manifestation is that way and why she's in pain. But that's the matter of, you know, technique, and it's the matter of what I teach and how you get there. But on the level where I do this, it's just natural in the most common sense of the word. Of course, the whole universe is natural. Anything that is not natural is what we do and what we think. This is where the problem is. But everything else that happens, from pain to ascending somewhere, that's all part of nature. Because whether you call it God, or you call it creator, or you call it nature, or you call it universe, it's all the same. And so we, for millennia, for thousands of years, people know what makes you alive, what a little living thing is, that life force, and may the force be with you. That chi, ki, prana, we call it bioenergy because it's the same thing. It means bios as in Greek word for life, and energy as in energy. So it's a life energy. This is the same as the breath in prana or chi, whatever. This is the same thing. It just has a, like we call bread differently in different languages. But this is something that is everywhere throughout the universe. I don't really know about, you know, I do claim that what I use, this bioenergy, this chi, ki, prana, whatever, it is from a different dimension. But a different dimension only in the sense that we sense our dimension, our 3D or our 4D or whatever you want to call it, through our five senses that are connected to our brain and to our interpretation of that. So that's what makes our dimension. Now since, and I believe that this is from different dimension that I use because I've never seen it. I can't smell it, I can't touch it, I can't kick it around, I can't do anything. But I am totally convinced that that is there because I see how I can manipulate it and how I can see and observe its effects. And what I use this for is only for healing. This is, you know, this can be used for who knows what. I have no idea. But what I know and what I'm expert in is in using it for healing, which means there's a lot of healers out there. And we all, whether you guys like it or not, we all use the same energy. I do not use different energy than somebody else. There are better and not so good healers. Some are more handy and more, you know, better in their craft, which means that they manipulate this energy in a different way. For that, they, you know, you have to sort of understand how it works. And let me give you a $60,000 question right here, how it works automatically. It works by itself. We don't have to do anything. We just have to gather it from our environment. And when I say channel it, that has a lot of connotation, channel. We just put it into the other biofield, in other living being. This can be a person, person, it can be an animal, it can be a plant, anything that's alive has, uses this energy and is, you know, run by this energy. So that everything that this energy does, it does because of what it is. And nor you, nor I, nor anybody can change that. Some can understand it better, or some can understand it less. But that doesn't make a difference, because it, all the properties that this energy has are already contained in this energy. That's what it is. All the information that the energy has, it's already there. It's already there. This energy is information. Now comes the expensive part. It's there, and it's not, it's information about all of your, you know, your health, your illness, your life and death and everything. It's all there. It's all recorded and it's all contained there. And every single cell of your body, I'm talking about a physical body, is getting this information, or should be getting it for properly functioning. It has to have this information. Now, there's a lot of misnomers here, because the energy body and the physical body, it's all the same. Physical body is just a different frequency of the same energy body. It's just a little denser, it's a little dumber, and it's dumber because of what we think. Cells, I mean, most of your body works automatically. Because remember, you go to sleep and you still breathe and your heart still goes and your hormones are still secreted and blah, 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 blah. So there's no intention there. You either are alive or you're not alive. And when you sleep, 95% of what, you know, you do is governed by that automated, you know, nervous system, you know, which is, it's automatic. It, this is where bioenergy works, or chi or ki or prana. Then we have a little other part, which is also a part of the whole, which is our mind. And that's our brain, and especially the left side, which is a little rascal. Or a terrorist, if you want. Or a capitalist, or a corporation mind, because, you know, it's only me, only this. It's, you know, this is the only way. And if it doesn't, this is the whole true and nothing but the true, is that little 5%, or maybe 3%, in your left side of the brain. And it wants to govern, and that's your ego. But let's, you know, okay, so screw the ego. You can't, it's part of you. This is what we mostly make a mistake when we talk about holistic and holistic approach, and this is all one, and the oneness, which means it's all one. We are, everything that we are is one. You know, the oneness, and I hear this oneness, we all one. It doesn't mean that you are I or I am you. I mean, I'm sure you want to be me, but I do not want to be you. Sorry. I mean, my wife wouldn't let me, so forget it. But oneness means that everything is one. So your big toe and your pineal gland and your thoughts and your conditionings and your beliefs, it's all one. Just that this little part here is, you know, very powerful. And it's been powerful for the last, you know, mostly last 300-400 years, it's being really bad. And before then, it was just bad. So, but now it's really, really bad. Because it sees that, you know, what we were talking about before, what, you know, are getting more to the heart. So this is not the heart. This is the heart. So this here is trying to take over from the heart, which is, the heart is the part of your body that's connected to your subconsciousness. So brain is your command center and tells there's things to secrete this, and this pancreas has to do this, and oh, and your adrenal glands have to do that because you're afraid. You're always afraid. And then you're always in a fight or flight, mostly like flight, condition, and you get overworked with adrenaline, and then you get ill, and blah, blah, blah. So that is, this is what the heart that people were talking about is, why is this important. But on a physical level, the heart is actually the one that tells the brain what's going on with the rest of your organs. Which gland needs this or that. But of course, the brain, since the left side is so strong, is now using that power of you being afraid. So the fear is the biggest reason why we are ill. And the fear has many, you know, forms. Doubt is also because of fear. Because when you doubt something, you are, you know, afraid that it's not going to be true, or it's not going to happen. What if I do get ill? What if, you know, it's that doubt is actually fear. It's a worst possible emotion. Doubt, same with anger. Hope is bad, because you hope when you're not sure. So you hope this is going to work, but you're really not sure. Because why you're not sure? Because you've been told that you cannot be sure. Don't you dare being sure. What do you think you are, that you think that this is what it is? You always have to doubt. So this is, you know, it's very hard for us to get away from that. Now, why is this important? Because, as I said, everything happens automatically in healing. If we just bring in this information, and we address the goodness, we address the well-being, we address the health. The problem that we all healers have is that they want to address your illness. Illness is already there, and you want to remove the illness. But see, the illness didn't come from outside. It entered you now. This is what our language is also a problem. I got the flu. I got cancer. I got this from somewhere. Why me? Why did I get it? It's you. It's a part of you. So it's not that you got it from somewhere. It's in you. Now, we'll take it out. Well, we can't take it out. It's a part of you. It's that wholeness and the holistic. They're all about holistic, but you want to take something out. Now, doctors are easy. They just cut it out. You don't need that. Of course you need it. If it's there, you were supposed to need it. I mean, why would you grow and, you know, another arm? Maybe you don't need it. But if you had three arms, I'm sure you could be able to use it and use it well. So how I approach this, and what pure bioenergy does, I mean, my school of thinking, is that you are what you are. You are that perfect being. You're perfect in the sense that you were made to be healthy. Your original state of being is health. So now, when you got a problem, any kind of condition that bothers you, that means that your wholeness, your health, is diminished. I'm not adding an illness to your whatever you are. But that illness is taking a part of health away. So what we do, what I do, is I bring in the information that is contained in the bioenergy. Information of health, information of well-being. Because that's what you're missing. And then, you know, the immune system, blah, 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 blah. You know, so this is much more complicated, but it boils down to simplicity like that. It's not so much easy, but we like it more if we make it more complicated. Because then it seems more real, kind of, it's more, you know, this guy must be very smart if he can do all this. We are overthinking it. So let's do it. And it's not working. People are more and more sick and ill, and everybody's sicker and iller. So something is not working. So why don't we try the other approach? And this is what I do, and it works. Every condition is reversible. Every. Because you were born healthy, and you're supposed to, your natural state is health. But see now, Now we're going to that side of the brain again. Oh, this is incurable. And you hear this 500 times a day, every day. And then you see the pink ribbons and the yellow ribbons and the purple ribbons, whatever they have it now for. Alzheimer's awareness, I mean, sure. So the more we're aware of something, as people before me were talking about, why do you need to be aware of this or something? So you can bring in the manifestation of whatever, ascending or wherever you're going. So attention leads towards manifestation. See, intention is the focused attention towards a goal, manifestation, you know, whatever you're going. That's what brings it there in your consciousness. So this is the process. So when you come to me and you ask me, so, you know, I have this, my aura apparently is gray and my this here is purple. What do you want me to do about it? So, why am I, you know what? I don't know and I don't care. It's like it's not, it's your body, it's your health, it's your responsibility. But we were told that, you know, you, and especially if you have more money, then it's easier because then you can get to better doctor or to more doctors. But guess what? The rich people's children are just as sick. And die and they get older. Movie stars die of the illness and they should certainly be able to afford, you know, whatever, you know, for somebody else to fix it. Nobody can fix it. The body is the only one that can heal itself. So now, of course, so now I go like, okay, fine. Okay, heal. Well, you can't. You don't know how to because your mind is telling you all kinds of lies and all kinds of illusions and delusions and whatever. So it's good to have somebody that can facilitate the process. But it has to facilitate the process in your body so that your body will kick in that self-healing which is innate in you, your self-healing process, and you will get rid of it. Now, and this is why, you know, sometimes it just happens like that, and sometimes we have to work hard on people. I mean, they have to work hard on themselves in order to get that done, because there's a lot of other influences. Everything, you know, we say pure bioenergy bioenergy is pure only when there's no additives to it, where there's no conditioning, cultural, political, economical, whatever. This is, because this is all in your thoughts. Your thoughts are not your thoughts. You think with somebody else's head. But you know what? Universe, fortunately, works without sanction of CNN and BBC and whatever. You know, sun comes up every morning, what are they? They even sometimes wrong with the weather. I mean, they say it's not gonna rain and then it's pouring. Or maybe it's just in my house, but you know, so it's not, nature doesn't need our sanction. And guess what? You're a part of nature. And so is your cancer. And so is your whatever you have. But what's the problem? Problem is that you're afraid. And that freezes you in that process. So this is why my work isn't that simple and isn't that easy, because I have to get you on that non-conscious level to cause those transformations that are needed for you to start thinking and acting differently, for you to stop believing CNN or whatever. I mean, for CNN, anybody else, everything that you know what the hardest thing that, you know, I've been doing this for like 12 years, and it's amazing, it just changed my life. But you know what is the hardest thing? When you do this long enough and you see all these results, and I'm not going to tell you healing stories because there's a book, every healing has a story, and that's only about 100 and something stories. I mean, we have thousands. So that, what's the hardest is that seeing those results, it's not me having that, my clients have those results. Once you see what happens, then you realize that everything you ever learned is not true. And I went to school and university and got degrees and PhDs and blah, blah, blah. But that is Tennessee, that, you know what, that really doesn't actually work. It's really not the truth. And I have to, every day I have to go, well, just, but, you know, okay, I know this because, see, what makes a knowledge? When I tell you something, you can believe me or you cannot believe me. And that's, that still isn't the truth, or isn't the, you know, you don't know it. You will know it once you experience it. Not just a healing process, but once, you know, if you do what I do and you know that you can do this and you see that you can do this and that you can teach somebody that can do this, then you see that that's true. Before, when I just tell you, you know, this is fantastic, that's good, thank you very much, and I don't want to take too much of your time. But once you try it and you see the results like I did, or a couple of thousands of my students do it, then they know that this is possible. But so what I'm saying is I'm not gonna take too much time about telling you what it, this is and how this works, because you have to experience it. And the learning of this, of course we have seminars and we teach you a technique of how you can do it, and then you will know how to do it. But I have to, people, this is such a great word, you know, the human superpowers, but it's just, wow. I never think of it that way, but it's, you know, why not? So I have to show, when I get the students, and I'm, you know, because now, of course, you can all sign up for a seminar. I expect. And your family. So, but then, I have to, when you come to my seminar, now, you know, this is fine, you came here because of Michelle and Greg and, you know, to listen to, and, you know, so now I'm talking to you. But you will not really experience it or believe it before, unless you try. So now when you come the first day, I have to, now you're all a little skeptical, and rightly so, why wouldn't you? So what I have to do, I have to demonstrate the superpower. What is a superpower here? Is there something, or, you know, miracles or whatever, there's something that we don't know, we can't explain with the normal tools of science or whatever, you know. So what I do, this is what, you know, there was a whole list of stuff that Michelle had her, you know, with the psycho this and psycho that, and, you know, we do a couple of those things, and we do psychokinesis. We do psychokinesis, it's one reason why we use it, why we demonstrate it, is to, in the class, is to show people what I can do, and then in the next, before the first day is over, before Friday night, you will be doing the same thing, right there. So, and that is what we use this on clients, on the ill people, is what we want to, we need to reach them on a non-conscious level, subconscious or supraconscious or whatever, on a non-conscious level, to cause those transformations. But it is not, you know, when I tell you something, that's rational, that's on your conscious level. I need to reach you somewhere down there or up there, wherever that is. And that shift has to happen there. So I have to show you that I can reach you there. And this is not a hypnosis, this has nothing to do with hypnosis. It's actually really a physical thing. Just not the Newtonian physics, it's more maybe quantum, I don't know. I really don't understand quantum physics. I mean, you may, but I don't. And very few people do. But what is very close to what we do in quantum mechanics is that it's not something is and something isn't. That whatever is and isn't at the same time. And is a possibility of all of these possibilities at the same time. And then when we, you know, collapse it, then it becomes something. But so that potentiality, that endless potential. And I mean, your little cancer must be a part of that too. So it just goes. So everything is, and the timeline. There's no timeline the way we understand it. So in quantum physics, everything that was, also is in the future at the same time. So you're ill now, but you're also healthy now. I was healthy before, but no. If all is one, then you are, as you are ill, you are also healthy. Just you don't rationally, your left side doesn't let you believe that. So you don't accept it. But when that transformation on an unconscious level happens in the way you think and act, that's going to happen. That's that quantum leap. And I can't explain it to you, or can't tell you, this is what you have to do. You know, like, what was the Barbara Bush? Oh, just don't do it. Yeah, the drugs, you know, like, no, just don't take drugs. Okay, fine. That's as simple as it is, you know. Oh, but I'm so nervous. I'm totally, you know, oh, just don't worry about it. Yeah, that's the stupidity of it. So this doesn't work. So it has to work downward somewhere when it will cause that transformation. And for that, I have to show my client and my student, whoever my client, the possibility of that. And I have to show them how simple that is. Because if it's very complicated, then, you know, we can all go study for 6 years and then get a PhD, and we know a lot about less. And so what's the point? We have to show how simple it is, how the sun will come up tomorrow morning, whether the CNN says yes or no. It's still, you know, then those apples were falling on Newton's head before I realized what it was. It's, that's just, so bioenergy is a part of nature. Now, what I do is governed only by the laws of nature. No laws of state of Florida or state of California or law of attraction or law. They all exist. But what, how this works is only through and by the law of nature. The universe, as Darcy says, it's hilarious. It really is. It is, it's very simple. But why it's simple? Because it's there already. We don't have to invent it. We don't have to use it in a special way. So what's the problem? So, well, the problem is that we all want to use it in a special way. We all want to make it complicated. Because if I make something sound very complicated, then you actually, with the rational mind, are going to trust it more. Are going to believe it more because, gosh, you know, it must be, so this guy's very smart. I mean, he knows all that. How can he remember all that? So this must be, there must be something there. And that's actually pure chichimichi. Chichimichi is a technical term that we have for bovine feces. We don't do any chichimichi in our practice. It's all the way it is, by and through nature. So the only thing, the only chichimichi is me, or would be me, would be you once you start doing it. Because you will add the chichimichi to it. And so, well, how am I going to teach you not to use all kinds of bullshit that you learned in other schools and in other universities and in other states? So what we do is we remove ourselves from the process. Because how can I know that if you, let's say you are all my class and you're my students, how can I know what you know from before, what you're going to use, how conditioned you are in your thinking? And we all are conditioned. If you went to school, if you were born on this world, in this civilization, you're conditioned, period. And it's not just that you're a little more, a little less, we're all totally conditioned. So there you go. So since I don't know how you're going to be chichimichiing it, it's the best if we remove ourselves. What does meditation do? In order not to think, you know, because we have to, you know, what is killing us? The chatter. So, okay, so maybe we'll have the right things to think. No, that's what church tells you. If you want to quiet your mind, you have to stop everything, stop the chatter. Some of that chatter may be good. I mean, I don't know. Just quiet it. Quiet your mind. This is what is the purpose of meditation. And then things open up. And there's a, so, same principle. If I don't know what you're going to think, then I will ask you to please don't think anything. Well, it's hard. Because you can't, you know, it's hard. It's actually easier than you think. But we were told it was hard. Because if you want to really meditate for real, you might as well take a teacher and, you know, learn meditation. Because not every self reflection and this is not meditation. It's good, but it's that meditation is actually slipping in between the thoughts and making that space bigger and bigger and bigger, and it's quiet. That is, you know, it's not easy. Now, you better get a good teacher. Oh, everybody's a good teacher. And the more expensive one is even more better. So it's, everything becomes every knowledge becomes valuable. What I'm doing, they knew thousands of years ago. Every Buddhist priest knew that, or monk, or whatever. And I'm saying Buddhist because they're kind of better than the, you know, Catholic priests. But stop it, don't go there. So there is, but even they realize that, you know what, knowledge is power. You know, so if I tell everyone how simple this is, well, what's my value then? You know, so why would you come to me and take my seminar? Ah, I got away, don't worry about it. But so what we do, I'll pay the money and I'll show you. But it is really actually that simple. But the hard part is to remove yourself from the process, and to remove yourself as far as even from the results, from the, you know, not caring about the result. Now that's very hard because you are a compassionate person, you have this, you know, empathy, and you want to help, and this is what I'm doing, so to make this person feel better. No. You're just channeling in the energy. And if you really want to help, if you're really an empath, if you are such a compassionate goody-goody, then, you know, you will work on your mother. Don't you want to help your mother? Yeah, you know, so I have to, it's my mother. Okay, that's your ego too, it's your mother, and you know, I have a mother too. So, if the more I want to help my mother or my son, the more I have to go away. Now that's very hard, it's very strange in our concept, because you like them, you love them, you want to embrace, you want to give them more attention. But you will do more if you do less. By doing less, you're actually achieving more. So what we do is very simple, but what happens is a totally and completely, you know, it's a complex thing, which is the whole. And you know, I don't know what happens. The same as when somebody says something is impossible, they're implying that they fully understand the workings of the universe. And we know they don't. So if somebody says something is impossible, we know it's chichimichi. Now, so how can I say? I can say it's possible because I can show results. But to explain it. And guess what? What difference would it make? You know, you go to a doctor and tell you that you have an incurable disease, but you know what? It's genetic. Oh, okay. Now that makes it good. Now you're really, you know, not worried anymore. Because you know what, honey? I have this disease. I'm going to die next week, but it's genetic. So, you know, what can I do? What does that mean? If you know, so somebody explained because they are, you know, a doctor or somebody, then that makes it better. It doesn't. So now let's say that the day we don't take them as authority, but we take me as authority because I'm this big healer. What difference is it going to make? We're talking about a problem. And problem is what you want to get rid of. So all I can do is talk about solution, not about a problem. Talking about a problem is a waste of time. And gets your left side even more active about that. So we are only addressing the solution. I don't know why I brought this, because there's something else written here. So we deal only with the solution, not with the problem. Now, you have to get there through, you know, you have to reach those people on that non-conscious level. So this is why we do perform psychokinesis. And there's a lot of, you know, throughout the process, which takes from 10 minutes to half an hour. If you have an MS or Parkinson's, it'll take 47, 48 minutes. I mean, just because we have very precise protocols of what to do and how to do it. And why is that important? Because then, if you know, if there's a structure, then you, at the way we are, with all our mind and our left side of the brain, then we will trust it more, and we will not have to worry about it. The biggest off switch for the energy healing is doubt. That doesn't mean you have to believe it when you come to me. But I certainly cannot doubt it. I doubt the flow of energy will just stop. And I know we control the direction of the energy, how it goes and where it goes, and only that direction and this and that. So, as we all explained in the seminar, why we don't scan, why we don't diagnose and stuff, and it's useless, it doesn't matter. You know, so you will tell me what the manifestation is. You're going to say, I have a lung problem here, and so work on the lungs. Done, over. And you, your body, and your psyche, and your everything else that you are, your spirit, your soul, will work on the rest of it. And that will cause healing. So, it makes it a lot less sexy if I, it's this and that. That's good. But it's not useful. In other words, if I don't need something in healing, if you don't need something in healing, that is redundant and that shouldn't be there. Universe only does what needs to be done. When the planets go wherever they go and sun comes up, it comes up every day the same way, maybe in a different place, but the same way. It doesn't, now it's the 5th of January and I'm going to do a little wiggle. I mean, because it's a, what's the wiggle? It has its, why the sun doesn't wiggle? Because it doesn't have to wiggle. Because it doesn't think it should wiggle. So it just comes up. So we are always, of course, prone to wiggle a little bit and that kind of, So this is what makes what I do different. And, we have all the techniques, everything we use, make this process happen. But we have all kinds of supporting tricks in this technique. And one of them is psychokinesis. So if you can do it now. Now what I'm going to show you is just a couple of minutes of, this is from our classes. This is what me and my students do in our classes. And it's showing the superpowers. But it's not, there'll be some of me doing it, but most of it will be my students doing it as a part of the class. And all these people obviously have all these superpowers. And all these people learn this, what you will see, in literally 20 minutes. And Michelle was in my class, she knows how, it's the first day, the first 20 minutes, you learn how to do this funny stuff. And that's a lot of fun. But it serves, it's called psychokinesis, which, meaning moving things by psyche without physically touching something, you're moving it. And that shows people the superpowers. And we tell them there's no secret. I mean, everybody's got a superpower. If Canadians can go learn it in 20 minutes, then I guess you can learn it too. Any Canadians here? I first wanted to say Michelle, but I said, okay, shit, it's very bad. It's very bad. I can't put it. So anyway, sorry, Canadians. But this is. So let's look at this. It's a couple of minutes, and then we can, ask a question. I will explain some things, but it's you will see people not being touched, doing silly stuff. Please.
Same thing at a distance, okay? The dowel going over there. Thank you. the group on the left is pulling the people on the right towards them just by their eyes. And this guy didn't want to levitate.
Talking to them while they're doing this too, or no talk?
No talk.
See, this is not what we do this for. It's not a sideshow. It's not a circus. It's not something we would, you know, we don't play with this. We do on seminars and we show so you can see as a student what can be done. And that you too can learn it, and it's very simple and very fast. So you just do what I show you and it happens. When we use it on clients, we use it to access their non-conscious level. We're knocking on the ice there, down there, to say, look what's possible. So this is, and we don't tell them and say, look, I'm going to do this. And we just do what we do, and then they can't control themselves. So, but what is the point of why we teach it and why we use it is that if this is possible, if it's possible to learn it in 20 minutes, and I'm not exaggerating, if you can learn it in 20 minutes to do this, then how big of a problem is one little leukemia? I mean, you know. It's what I'm saying is, this is why we do this. It's to show the potential of their own, you know, of our hints. So we just facilitate the process, but it all, that's why we don't talk to them, because that's on a rational level. It all has to happen on a non-conscious level. So we had to divide. I mean, this is not invented by me. This is done all over the world, and for all kinds of reasons. But this is manipulating the aura, the biofield. We, you know, I can move it, I can pull it. You know, I'm pulling the aura above my arm and it goes up. You know, I can physically grab it. Even though I don't see it, I don't feel it when I grab it, but, you know, it's actually very simple. So this is, but see, what this is what I do, and this is what's different from other healing modalities. Because we don't bring in any of our own knowledge. So you don't have to do this. You don't have to know anything about arthritis. What difference is going to make? You have to be an expert in what we do in manipulating this bioenergy, this energy body, and then the rest will happen automatically. So it is really, you know, it is really simple. You know, the quantum mechanics and quantum physics has been around exactly 100 years, 101 year. I don't know when they came out with it, was it February or May, but it's 100 years ago. And if you go study physics in university, you will be touching the quantum physics and you will be learning something about it. But it never trickled down to anything that is useful for us. It never trickled down to biology, to chemistry, God forbid medicine. It just didn't. It's too complicated. It's too much, you know, they have to change too much. So they, you know, and it's, what are you going to be afraid of if this is all possible? And it's, you know, what happened to me once I started doing this, I'm just not afraid. Fear disappears. When you see what's possible, and this is silly stuff, this is not important, but you have people that cannot get rid of migraine, you bend them over and leave them there for 5 minutes, go talk to somebody else, have a coffee, and come back, they'll go up and no more migraines. It's, you know, people are used to being in control, the control freaks. You have, you know, people need their illness, people need their fears, this is all conditioning. However in your head it is, it doesn't matter, it's still real. For them it's real, the pain is real, it's debilitating, they can't go to work. Whether they maybe don't want to go, but that's not for me to. It's one of the things we do, or we don't do, when we do what we do, we're not judgmental. Because, you know, it is not. This is why the less I know about you, the less I know about how you think of your illness, the easier it is for me to work. Because every whatever they're now popular, you know, lupus or fibromyalgia. That fibromyalgia is a disease, it's usually women, but it can be men too. But it's a general unhappiness disease. You're so unhappy that you start hurting and you can't get up to go to work or to, you know, do something about your children or your household or whatever. It's because of unhappiness. But see, to me, I know that doesn't, how am I going to make you happy? Give you $100 or ice cream or what is that? That doesn't make you happy. So, you know, we work on that head and heart areas to try, you know, for you to, we will not take the reasons of your unhappiness away. If your boss is a hard person to deal with, or your husband is a sphincter, or something, that is, I can't get rid of your husband. And who am I to get rid of your husband? I mean, what would give me that right? But I can help you so your attitude will change. And you will look at it differently and will be able to cope with it. But if it's, and, or you will make up your mind to leave and go away and change a job. But if I know, this is why I don't need to know, I don't want to know, that your job is really not good for you. But you need your job, so I can't tell you, well, go get another job. Well, easy to say. But, so, and that's not my responsibility. Your job, your health, your decision, your. And we're always into me, except for when it's like, you know, I have to get better. It's, no, you do it. Well, so, this is, you know, this is the, this is that, this is how much of the quantum mechanics and quantum physics we use in entrainment, in entanglement, in all these things that are like, this is part of the quantum physics. That is just a little helper for us to get into your subconscious, to make you change your way you think and act. Because that's the definition of healing. It's the transformation of the way you think and act. Because you are always just thinking and acting, you're acting the way you're thinking. So this is why that watch what you think is so important. And I would even go further than the previous speakers that, you know, it's very important that you are positive, and, you know, we get in this a lot. We get too much, again, rationally on the left side of our brain. So far that if you're not thinking positive, now you're getting stressed about you're not thinking positively enough. And that's the same stress as from anything else. You're getting stressed about, oh, I didn't drink enough water. Because 5 years ago, you were told you have to drink this much water, or 10 years, whatever. And now if you don't follow that direction, which is conditioning, I mean, if you're thirsty, please, by all means, drink. And if you're dehydrating, please drink. But if you now didn't drink, oh my God, now you're stressed about not drinking enough. And stress, that's from fear comes stress. So this is the only, every reason, I mean, it's different, the injuries and stuff is different, but every other condition that you get, that you develop, is from stress. And so, but it can be as simple as being stressed about, I'm not thinking positively enough. So you have to be careful not to, you know, it's very reasonable. I mean, just, you know, common sense. Come on, you know. Oh my God, I'm afraid. Of what? Of I'm not afraid enough, or I'm too afraid. Of, there you go, it's nothing. So we have to do, we get to reach you down there to change the way you think and act. And it's very easy for me. I'm not afraid of anything. I'm not going to stand in front of a running train or a bus because I'm not afraid of it. I mean, I am, so I'm not going to do that, but I'm not afraid of other things. So when you, you know, want to see, it's a wrong way to think that you want to be protected and you're going to have some protection. That's the externalization of the problem. Protection has to come from you. Not by excluding other things, but embracing them. That's the oneness. So when you are trying to tell yourself that, you know, I'm not allowing this in, I'm not, don't say that, because that's excluding, that's actually negative. It's, why don't you think of all the energies that belong to you, return to you in the form of a healing light, from all those friggin' energy zombies that are sucking it from you while you're having good time, just demand your energies back. Don't close yourself off from anything, because you're closing yourself off from good stuff too. And we don't need to know this is good, this is not good. That's conditioning too. That's your judgmental of what's good, what's not good. All that belongs to you, that's a part of your whole, your healthy self, should come back to you in the form of a healing light. And everything that doesn't belong to you, that belongs to them, should return to them in the form of a healing light. So now you've been really good to yourself and to the zombies. I mean, zombies need, you know, they need that blood or whatever they suffer, you know. It can be, you know, you can't, you know, you love roses, but then there are these little black bugs on it. They are living things just as well. You can't be, you know, your personal choices cannot, that's not good. You know, you can't be judgmental in that sense. Not just, you know, we're all so good and everything is peachy groovy, but look at her hair, I mean, for Christ's sake. So it's, So it is. So I'm saying we just, so in order not to, you know, don't put, it's too complicated. Just let everything be good. The zombies are good too. Let them have all their energies and let you have all yours. Thank you very much. And then you're not afraid of zombies. You're not afraid of zombies. You're afraid to go to a strip club, because there will be a thing about it. This is what you're afraid of. You're afraid of your wife. I mean, this is, let's be serious here. So this, but what I'm trying to tell you is that what I do is way, way more pedestrian than this whole big thing. We're trying to help people on the, with their material manifestations, first chakra, material manifestations of their problem. How, I mean, I will not, we don't have we don't have the protocols for rising your kundalini or whatever, because that's a different technique. But we have protocols for arthritis, we have protocols for cancer, for asthma. 5,000 children every year die of asthma in this country. It takes 4 days to get rid of asthma. It's ridiculous. So this is where I am, and this is where I want to stay. But then, of course, while you do this, we just channel this. We don't add any of our own, because I'm not good enough. I'm not the whatever, divine, to add any of my own knowledge that I learned in school, by the way, mind you, that I will add to the to your well-being. Are you, hello? Would you like any of my own understanding of this to reach you on your well-being level? So I don't offer any of my own. It's all in the energy. So that's why we remove ourselves, because we don't think we should. How, who am I to tell you this and that? You know? So we just channel the energy from the environment through our body, goes through our hands and through our eyes and tips of the fingers. So that good knowledge of well-being keeps going through me every day, hours and hours. Every time I work, things go through me. So me as a hose, as a pipe, as a vessel, am very well served. And that information of well-being is also the same information for my well-being. So I get benefits of it all the time, just by working. And you all of a sudden, you know, I don't use the word download, but you get the information all the time. And as you work, it's a, you know, you learn through working. It, you know, experience as such is good for the techniques, and it makes you better and, you know, in certain specific things, moves and stuff like that. But the knowledge comes through working. And it's it doesn't come in the form of a booming voice, you know, Zoran, this is how it is. Maybe that's their cognizance or whatever. It just, you know, after year you work, is you just know things, and but it doesn't mean you have to go out and, you know, push them to you and on you and saying, you know, well, I just found out, listen to this. It's not that way. But it might work on reaching you on an unconscious level, we'll get easier and faster and stronger. So there's a whole, you know, whole benefit system here that not just you benefit, but me too. And so you see, it's there was said many times this today that you grow by working for others, and it's true. This is why I think, and I'm worry of this self-improvement, self-development, self this, self that. It's ego-oriented by definition, self this, self that. And you will not grow by working on yourself, because it's still just for yourself. But when I work for others, when I learn from working for others, that's where I grow. I grow by doing things for others. And it is, I guarantee you, I mean, I don't know about you, but I did. I changed and I grew by and through working for others. It doesn't mean that, you know, I'm, you know, the service, and you can call me at 11:15 on a Saturday night. I mean, it doesn't, you know, but you work, you help yourself by working for others. And so, what is the better way of working for others and growing through that, as in healing? Because everybody needs it. I mean, guys, let's be real. Everybody needs help. Everybody, and I don't think it should be that way. And I don't think it's necessary. I think that half of it can be done like this, could be just gone. But we are told that we are sick and we're going to get sicker. When you are in the mall and you see that the next year there will be 60,000 more diabetics in this county because there's a drive for it. I mean, this is information you're getting. You're just getting information that everybody is sicker and is going to get sicker. So there is, for me, there's a never-ending... That's my agent. There's a never-ending supply of people that need help. And so it's really cool. I mean, and you help people and it's there being helped. Amen. So I would like to... just want to make sure that I didn't sound wrong in the sense that there are many other healing modalities. There's other healers. There are healers that are, because I, as a healer, I don't do anything. I mean, I have nothing to do with you when I work on you, but I facilitate that, but it's not I that heal you. Then there are maybe people with the special abilities. For what I do, you don't have to have any special abilities. You don't have to be special, just a little different, but not special. But there are people that can do these things, whatever, wherever they pull them from, and I just don't know how to do that. But that's not important. The important is that what I do, what they do, they can teach you. What I do, I can teach you. And that's the difference. So, I don't know whether it's, John of God or George of somebody else. It doesn't matter. When he goes, however he does it, I mean, chapeau. But however he does it, you cannot do. But what I do, you can do. Darcy does it. You've seen other people there, that those are my students, they do it. And they do it very well. So it's not... This is the difference. It's just this is what I said. It's like a pedestrian kind of thing. It's like down to earth, natural, and only we don't do much. So I want to make sure that I didn't say that this is the best. There are people that can do way more than I can do. And also, I do have to say that I will not teach you what I can do. I'll teach you what you can do. But I learned it too. So it's not that I was born with it. I was actually hatched, but it's not. So this is what I want to make sure that you understand, that this is what, to me, the value of what I do is to help. This just to help normal people that have irritable bowel syndrome, and their chakras can be wherever they want to be. I mean, we do fix broken hearts too. I mean, especially if all the pieces are there, we can put it together. But it's not all this whatever. But it's I got the tennis elbow. It gets debilitating. When you live with pain for a while, you will change as a person. It'll be horrible. Who wants to live with you? So but in order to grow, you have to work for others, and you will grow only through the joy of learning, and you will learn only from others. I mean, what are you going to teach yourself? Zoran, you're so great. I'm great. No, I have to see what I've done and learn from you how great I am to be doing this, not my knowledge, but to be ready for you. That's, I think, is the goodness. So now I think... we should. What time is it? I was going to bring a phone to see what time it was. 6:20. I think we should. If you have any questions for me, but I also think that maybe we should open this to questions for all of our speakers for today. So it's not just me. Of course, I'm the prettiest, but that's different. But that's different. So let's if you have a couple of questions for me, but then I don't hesitate to ask other people. I mean, you have a question for Darcy or for Michelle, do that. Who was first? The lady in the back.
Can you mind coming up here, though?
Would you mind coming up here to ask the question? I would really appreciate it, so everybody could hear.
Huh? See how it feels, huh?
I just wanted to ask if in your workshops, if you do actually do healings, or if you're just training people to do healings?
No, the workshops are, that's a good question. I didn't want to, you know, make this as advertising for what I do. I mean, my, you know, seminars, although there's brochures there and you can find everything. But there is training and there's healing. When you come for a training for to be a healer, you just get a training, especially level one. Except now we do this also, we have a retreat in Joshua Tree in California, which includes, it's the level one plus healing. And it's a hotel and the food and food. It's a retreat. But normally the level one is 3 days, so Friday night, Saturday and Sunday, and you learn all the techniques to be able to do this. Then level two is more of the same. There's the dynamic of the group, because we feel that the best results, people resonate with the group the most. And so we will teach you all that and the long distance healing. And in order to understand the group and how the group works, you will be observing the group, but not as a healing, not as a client, but as a student. Sometimes we do some healing for some students, but they're two different things. And then we have healing events, and whatever, then that's for healing. Or there's private sessions, there's long distance sessions, whatever. You will find everything on our, you know, site. But when you come to the seminar to learn, it's learning. Yeah.
Right.
And also that, you know, you cannot, what I will teach you if you come is how to use this on another person. You cannot use this on yourself, because it's a laying on of hands. So you lay the hands on somebody to get the energy from the environment onto them. So you need your one potential, they're the other. So you can't pour the water from the same glass into the same glass. So you can't hold yourself. I mean, you can, you go, oh my God. But you don't, it's not going to work, because it doesn't, it has to flow into the other biofield, and this is what we teach you. So it's not, so if you need healing, make sure either you bring your husband with you to the seminar, or send him instead of you, so then he can work on you and you get the healing. Because otherwise, whoever that takes the seminar, then, you know, they're always without it at the end. they get the work, but they don't get the work done.
Zoran lives here on Siesta Key, so he does the in-person sessions, and you can contact him through the website, through the phone number.
Yeah, right? I live here, and I have my office here, and I'm gone a lot, but this is my base, and so it's...
And he also has long-distance healing. He can do it over the phone. You just have to be available for the 4 days.
And the therapy is 4 days. It's 4 days is one therapy. So.
It's only like 15, 20 minutes over the
phone.
Yeah,
it depends on your condition, but yeah, basically it's not very long.
You mentioned something that I've been struggling with for a long time.
I can't hear you.
Oh, sorry. You mentioned something that I've been struggling with for a long time, so maybe you can shed some light on it. You said that the biggest off switch for utilizing or channeling the healing energy is doubt.
Yes.
How do you take care of that? What do you do?
Doubt. Doubt will switch. It's a switch off for the energy. So how would you do? You have to stop doubting. Now, how do you stop doubting? Either you rationally tell yourself, I believe this, based on something, which is what you see or what you, or you actually, you know, start doing this in this way, and remove yourself, see the results, experience the results, and then why would you doubt? See, one of the reasons why I teach people psychokinesis the first night, the students. I mean, they're already paid, they're hit, so I don't have to buy them all over. I mean, I don't have to win them over. But if you could learn this in 20 minutes and you see the results, this is not your interpretation, it's right there. So that's the real knowledge, because it's a first-hand personal experience. That's the only knowledge there is. So when you see that, experience that, then you know it. So it is possible. Well, maybe I doubt it's possible. It is. You just did it. I told you what to do, and then you did this. So why would you doubt? I mean, what would you doubt? If you can learn to move a 200-pound person or 300-pound person that's this much bigger than you, We have people that do it kind of from the wheelchair, and they move person. So why couldn't you learn how to heal cancer? I mean, because you're not doing it anymore. It's the energy is doing it. That's the difference. And the difference is that this is why you don't have to doubt, because you can, of course you will doubt yourself. Who am I? I don't know, I'm not good enough, because you think you have to know something about cancer or whatever. You don't. And you see, I don't even call this energy medicine, because it's not medicine. This has nothing to do with medicine. Absolutely zero, zilch, nothing. Because medicine is a science about the problem, about the disease. And they research the disease. They don't research the health. But we, disease you already have. We have to address the health. But we think we have to approach this with the medical knowledge. Why? Why not plumbing knowledge or fashion design knowledge or something that is also very sexy? So it's why are we, this is the conditioning I'm saying. So when you put this conditioning aside, meaning it has nothing to do with this, so why should I worry? And you have specific protocols, exactly 3 minutes of that, 2 minutes of this. So why would you worry? You go to the beach, I mean, in your mind, you remove yourself. Have mojitos, see the palm trees, sailboats, puppies, whatever, you know. Well, I'm having a ball. It's great. And would you, do you want to, do I care about the tumor in there? The tumor. It's not the tumor. I don't care. It's a mojito. Take it. You know, I had an interview a couple of, you know, maybe a year ago in California, and it was called, you know, Rocking the World of Energy Healing. This world of energy healing has to be rocked, has to be shaken, and say, guys, what are you doing? Why are you thinking you want to be a doctor? Go to medical school. You want to act like that? You want to know about cancer? Go study cancer. This is not what we do. Don't misunderstand me. If you think the doctors would, go to the doctors. As a matter of fact, when you come to me, I will have you sign the thing that I'm not a doctor, and if you're sick, go to the doctor. That's a legality, of course. But once you've been there and they couldn't help you, you can do it. Did I answer your question? I'm sorry.
So for you.
Just do it. What did he say? Don't think, feel. And I said, don't think, do. Just do it.
So have you had any kind of self destructive programming that you think you might be dealing with? And maybe there's a lack of completely loving yourself and accepting exactly who you are and why you're here. Those things are kind of hard to believe unless you come to some place like this where you're full of people who are on the same path and are learning that as well.
That's because you're believing, you talked about believing on a rational level. This is your left side of the brain.
You're in your head.
Down here. And you know what? If it doesn't talk to you, don't worry about it. Then it has nothing to say. It's cool.
So how does it feel to hear that? How does this feel to you? Does it make you want to do it? Does it make you excited? I mean, you have to go with what's in here and follow this, not this. That's you. That's your left and right head, right side of the brain. We've got to merge that, and you're masculine and feminine, and everything that else.
You should hang out with horses.
Horses.
Horses. Horses have two sides of the brain, but they're both right.
So you have to learn to not take things so serious as it's life and death. It kind of is, but we've already died so many times. This is like our last time to go through that. Just have to lighten up a bit. My guides are always telling me, you've got to lighten up. Don't take it so seriously.
Unless you're from Syria.
Or serious, A or B.
Well, that's different.
Anybody else want to come up and ask a question?
Can I just yell mine real quick? I just want to know about mental illness. Have you had experience?
Same thing. See, there's no physical illness that isn't connected to the emotions and the psyche. So part of every protocol, part of every procedure is the mental and emotional part. So then there's no pain in the knee, then it's even easier. We don't have to deal with that. We just deal with the I see my beer getting warmer.
We're going to relieve you of your duties. Thank you so much, everyone. Give Zoran.
Thank you. Thank you very much for coming. And thank you for having me.